Welcome to Gadget Flow Podcast. After working with more than 6,000 customers since 2012, we've learned a lot about marketing, product placement, crowdfunding, and everything in between. In this podcast series, we'll have as guests crowdfunding project creators, C-level executives from the top marketing firms of North America and Europe, consultants, and industry experts. Make sure to subscribe in iTunes and check out our website at thegadgetflow.com.
What's up, people? Jessica Naziri here with the Gadget Flow Podcast, talking everything crowdfunding. Thanks for tuning in. On this podcast, we discuss the tips you can apply to your crowdfunding campaign, strategies and things you need to get backers, improve your chances of raising money from the crowd, and of course, building a crowd. Here we talk about the things you need to get people interested in what you're doing and support your project. And today we have a very special guest, Ran Khouri, with over 15 years of experience and an impressive collection of international advertising awards to his name. It's little wonder that Ran has dubbed the name as one of the most popular crowdfunding consultants. He has worked in the crowdfunding and marketing space for startups for the past 3 years, and it's not surprising to know that he has already used his expertise to raise millions of dollars for his clients. Today, he leads a team of specialists to provide entrepreneurs and startups with the resources they need to successfully crowd their project. If you want to know what makes a good crowdfunding video, listen up. We'll pick Ran's brain to find out some of the marketing techniques he's been using, strategies, and everything in between. Ran, I'm so excited to have you here on the podcast. Welcome.
Hi, Jessica. I'm excited to be here also.
Thanks so much. And I know you're in Israel right now and it's pretty late, so I'm really excited to take your time up.
Yeah, it's like 10 o'clock in the evening, yeah.
Okay, but, okay.
I'm always happy to chat with you.
Fantastic. So let's get straight into it. You have a massive track record with crowdfunding campaigns, but let's get back to the basics, to the beginning. What is your background in marketing?
So I have a first and second degree. I've done my master's in advertising. I learned in Europe. My two diplomas, and I worked for several years in Europe and also in Israel as an art director and creative director in the big advertising agencies. And I have done thousands of campaigns. Many of them were also very successful. I won international awards for creative campaigns, if it's the Cannes Lions and the London International Awards, New York Awards, Golden Drum, and others. And after many years in the advertising agencies, I decided to make a small shift and start helping startups, because I think I can help more startups grow, and this is one of the most important things for me, to see those startups start from a small group of people and become a big company after a few years.
Well, we're so happy to have you in the crowdfunding marketing campaign, because you have been doing some great work. Now, I'm really curious to know, what has been the hardest part about going from the advertising to crowdfunding marketing area? Where are you now, and what exactly was that difference like?
So there are a lot of things that are similar between advertising and crowdfunding, and there are a lot of things that are different. So the similar things are the fact that we're talking about people. In advertising and in crowdfunding, you're talking to people. So people love, people hate, people laugh, people cry. In all over the world, people are people. So it doesn't matter if they come from China, or if they come from United States or Europe or anywhere, people are people. So if you understand how to talk to people, and if you are listening to people and understand what they need, then you would know how to approach them, if it's for crowdfunding or if it's with advertising. But the difference between crowdfunding and advertising, that crowdfunding is more personal. People want to see the entrepreneur, they want to see the person behind the product, and they want him to succeed. Okay, they want him to see how he starts with the product, he makes it big, and how it all started, because they will know that he's doing the campaign. While when you're doing a campaign for a big brand, for Coca-Cola, you don't really know who's behind the brand. You know that it's a brand. So that's the difference, the main difference. People. It's all about people.
It's all about people. You're absolutely right. The people and the story and the person behind that technology. That's good information that you're giving us there. So tell us a little bit about the services you're offering at your boutique agency.
So in fact, we are offering a full service campaign service. So we're doing from the beginning to the end. That means that we're doing small market research to understand everything that is happening with the brand, with the competition, with the audience, with the market, with everything that we can understand. And we create a special creative strategy that is derived from our research. We take that strategy and we stick with it from start to end. We create all the content, the graphics, and the most importantly, we do the creative video. This is the part that I love, because the video is very, very important for crowdfunding, because 90% of people will look at the video and decide if they want to buy the product or not.
Wow, did you say 90%? 90%, did you hear that? 90% watch the video.
90%. Yeah, and if you ask your friends and you ask people around, you will see that it's true. I like to give lectures about crowdfunding, and each time I stand before a group of 100, 200, and 500 people, I ask them, who likes crowdfunding? Everybody raises their hand. Who saw the video? Everybody raises their hand. Who read the text? And you see a few hands raised. So people don't like to read. They don't like to do a big effort. So the video is very important. So we are doing that, and we are doing also one of the most important things on crowdfunding, the pre-campaign. So we are testing and studying and testing again what will work, what things that people will like, which images will work better, which phrases, which audience we should approach better, and we are getting big amount of emails of potential clients, potential backers that will want to buy the product. So once the campaign is live, we have a good momentum, and it helps create a good, successful campaign. And then during the campaign, we are using different strategies that we have to make it even more and leverage the big momentum of the beginning. So we are really doing a lot of efforts. And we are putting our hearts in, so the campaign will be successful.
Great. So we'll talk a little bit more about pre-campaign and post-campaign, but let's talk about the best campaign you've worked with and how much did they end up raising?
So I've done a lot of campaigns that raised hundreds of thousands of dollars and also millions. For example, the last campaign that we have done is called Silicon Lipo. And this is a targeted fat reduction device. And I must say that a lot of people were very skeptical about the fact that we will manage to be successful, and they didn't think that it would we would succeed, because there are really bad products in the market, and people lost faith in those kind of products. And the product is not cheap. It's a special product that they took the technology from the clinics. That is a proven technology and shrank it to home use. So a lot of people didn't think that we will manage. And at the end, we managed to raise more than $1 million.
Oh, wow. $1 million. Wow. Okay. Yeah. So I'll give you my home address after we speak. I definitely want to try that out. That sounds great.
I don't think that you need it.
Thank you. So, you know, my question is, how did that look when it came down to it? Many campaigners think that, okay, they have an amazing product and all they need to do is upload a video and backers will come. But we all know that is not the case. How important is the creative thinking in the world of crowdfunding and the video and the social media and the PR you put into that?
So in fact, you talked about different aspects, okay? First of all, the video is super important because, like I said, 90% of the people look at the video. Second of all, a lot of people, what they do, they see crowdfunding campaigns, they copy it, and they think that it will work for their brand. And hope it doesn't work because suddenly all the crowdfunding campaigns look the same. Mm. If you look at the most successful campaign, they're trying to do it differently. They're trying to do to make it more creative. They're trying to show it in a different way, to film it in a different way. So they don't look the same as all the rest. And the other thing that will make the campaign successful is you can't just have a good video. You also need to do all the pre-campaign, and you also need to get all the family and friends and get tons of mailing list of people that want to buy your product once you launch and create a good momentum in the beginning.
And what does the best advertising do or need to do? Are there some marketing strategies that you use for every campaign that you work with? Do you go with, you know, maybe some sort of music to set the tone, or is it you want people to walk away feeling empowered, or does it really depend on each campaign? Like, what is the goal and what are some of the strategies you put into these videos?
So it really depends on the product, okay? There are different products need different strategy. For example, I had a campaign for what was called Peek-a-Poo. It helps you collect, it's a collection bag for dogs' poo. And we did a very humoristic video and we reached 300 million views.
I saw that. That was funny. I don't even have a dog. And I'm like, okay, if I had one, I would love this. I actually remember that.
Yeah, so yeah. A lot of people liked it and shared it, and it was amazing. I never had so many shares and 300 million views. That's amazing. And yeah. The amazing thing that the client, after the campaign, got so many distributors calling him. Every day he got like 10 or 15 people calling him and wanted the product because they saw it everywhere and everybody was talking. And another way to see that your campaign is successful is that the next day on eBay, everybody's copying your campaign and taking your pictures and video and having as if it was their own product on eBay and Amazon.
What does happen in that case?
I just need to sue them and ask them to take it off. But this is something I'm not doing for them. I'm not a lawyer.
Oh, so. Yeah. Okay, we're going to have to go research that for our next podcast together for sure. And so something that's a great story, you know, and like you said, you need to know your audience. It depends on the product to see what kind of video you'd be putting out there and the tone you use and the different types of social media. But, you know, crowdfunding today is just completely different to how it was 2 years ago. Every year it's changing. Every year journalists get more bombarded with emails and, you know, it's really hard to get a write-up. So let's talk about that for a minute. It's obviously growing year over year, but where do you see it going? And for those people who are trying to get attention, what is the strategy there?
So the first strategy is to have a great product. You know, it's not really a strategy and everybody says, yeah, that's obvious, but it's not that obvious because if you see a lot of campaigns are just doing the same things as other campaigns. If you have one successful campaign for a special cable for smartphones, then the next day you have another five campaigns like that. So you need to have good product, very interesting, because if not, reporters, they already talked about a similar product. It's not news for them, and they are always searching for news. They're always searching for something that the readers will be interested in and not reading the same thing again and over again. So first of all, you have to have a good product. Then you have to have a great campaign that will talk about people and not about the product. People will need to see why the product is good for them and not why the product is good. They will need to see how it's going to affect their life, how they would like to use it, and find what was missing in their life and how this product can help them. and not whoa, that product is doing that. So this is very important.
Absolutely. And now, when it comes to crowdfunding, how do you decide what's right for you, whether that's Indiegogo, Kickstarter, and why?
So first of all, the two platforms are amazing. Okay, I'm using them both. Sometimes I'm doing campaigns on Indiegogo, sometimes on Kickstarter. Each one of them has the benefits, the pros and cons. Okay, for example, Kickstarter is almost twice as big as Indiegogo. They are very big and they have a good traffic and they have a lot of what, as we call it, super backers, people that like to buy more and more products on Kickstarter and are searching for products on Kickstarter. And you have communities. But for example, on Indiegogo, they are very helpful and they try to help you and they can review your campaign. And if they see that you need the help, they will put you in a newsletter so you have more people to talk to. And also, for example, on Kickstarter, you cannot put a Facebook pixel for remarketing. And on Indiegogo, you can. And remarketing is a very good tool to sell more products. And for example, you can do a lot of things that you cannot do on Kickstarter. And for example, if you have a product that has medical claims, then you cannot put it on Kickstarter, but you can put it on Indiegogo. On Indiegogo, you have in demand. That is very good. So you can do a 2 or 60 days campaign and then continue and leave it open for as long as you want, because you can see that after the 60 days, you still have people that are searching for your product and you can continue raising on more money. So you really need to see what is your product, what are the similar products that are in the two platforms and which one of them perform better in which platforms, and like that you need to decide. But there's no one better platform than the other. I like them both. You need to decide what you like better.
Okay. Is there a hard and fast rule in terms of what does success look like for a crowdfunding campaign? Is it a certain percentage that needs to, a goal percentage that you need funding for the first day? Or what does that really look like in terms of success when it comes to crowdfunding?
So one of the most important thing is the preparation. So once the campaign is live, you will have a good momentum. So you need to have a big mailing list and you need to have all your family and friends that will help you. You need to contact all the reporters before the campaign is launched. If you can create an embargo, that means that you will tell them, okay, if you can, this is the date of the launch. Only after that date, you can talk about my product. So you must create a lot of buzz once the campaign is live. Okay, don't wait and start doing all the work once the campaign is live, because then it's too late. The campaign is dead. You need to give the first boost on the first days. And I try for my campaigns to pass the goal on the first day. And that also gives people a sense of a success story, and people like to join a success story.
Ah, I see. So would you say maybe the biggest issue in the market right now is lack of awareness, not preparing in time, or maybe even the platforms that don't allow you to do everything you need to be successful?
I think that if you have a good product, you have a good preparation, you know exactly where you need to be, and you have a lot of people following you, and you have created a good buzz. And you have a good budget for ads and everything, you have a big chance to be successful.
And for the people who don't necessarily have a budget for PR and social media, they can find other ways, or they can do it themselves, right?
Yeah, of course. So journalists What they are searching for is news. They are searching for things that will interest their readers. So it doesn't mean that only PR agencies, they only talk to PR agencies. So they even like better to talk to the entrepreneur, so they ask him the real questions. And so if you are doing the research for yourself and finding exactly all the reporters that will be interested in your product and talking to them, sometimes you can do it even better than a PR agency. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. You know, like they are professionals, but you can also do it by yourself. And I know a lot of people that do the PR for themselves and did it well. You need to be more creative, find new ways how to promote your product. You need to be more active on social media, on Reddit, on Product Hunt, on Facebook pages, anywhere that your audience is. You must be there. You need to ask all your friends and family to come and help you. The more people that will help you, the better success chance you will have.
Absolutely. The competition is enormous. You definitely need to be different. You need to attract attention and, like you said, be creative. And so what are some of the things you learned and things that our audience can take away when trying to prepare for a campaign? What are some tips for first-time crowdfunders?
So first of all, there are a lot of things to learn about crowdfunding. You should know that if you're doing a crowdfunding, it's not like 1 hour in the evening after work. I will check out what people say. It's a full-time job, and you need to, if you're going to do it alone, you need to learn it. It's like learning something new, and there's a lot of things that you can read online. It's possible. It's very hard, but it's possible. Okay, so you need to make the extra mile and work day and night and find all the resources that you can get to make it successful, because the competition is really, really hard. You need to think outside the box when you're doing the campaign, especially the video. Try to find all the best ideas and even a good photographer, that it will look as professional as possible. Because people today like to buy a product and not an idea. And like crowdfunding has changed in the last few years. So try to make it as professional as possible.
Yeah, you said that, you know, product, not an idea. Crowdfunding is continuing to change. So where do you see it going? What is it going to look like in the next few years?
I think that crowdfunding started as a way to help entrepreneurs bring their ideas into life. But after several failures of big campaigns that raised millions, people are starting to want to put the money and get the product. Okay, they don't want to invest in ideas. They want to invest in product that they will get. Okay, maybe after 3 months, 6 months, maybe a year, but they want to get the product. And that's the big difference between a few years ago and today. People want to get the product, and when they don't get it, they are very unsatisfied. So I think that today, crowdfunding, instead of only having a prototype, people are trying to make to sell or to show the product in later stages of even a few minutes before production.
So it's less of prototypes on these crowdfunding campaigns, more of like ready to release products, but they need the money to make it happen.
Yeah,
I see.
They need the money, and it's not about money. Okay, I tell people that if they want to do a crowdfunding for money, then it's not the place for them. Okay, because first thing, the money is not enough. Okay, even if you do a crowdfunding campaign and you raised 100, 200, it will not be enough to create your product. It depends on the product, but normally it's not enough. After that, you would need an investor and you would need more money. So the main idea in my eyes today is that crowdfunding is a very great tool to show a success story, to show, to get exposure, to create a community, to have followers, to feel the water, to talk to people, to understand what they want, to make some adjustments in your product because you are listening to people. And that's very and most important things for crowdfunding, and people should use it. This is one of the reasons that you see also big companies like Bose, that they did a crowdfunding campaign for headphones that cancel snoring noise. And they did the campaign for 10 days, they raised 400K, and they closed the campaign because they saw there's a big demand. They talked to people, they understand what they needed, and now they're producing the product, and they know that there's a demand, a big demand for the product. So they got what they wanted.
Wow, so it's not just small entrepreneurs or serial entrepreneurs. Now the big brands are jumping ship as well, or coming on board as well. I see. Yeah. Okay, well, switching gears, what inspires you, Ron, as an entrepreneur?
So what I like to see is the companies grow, because when people come to me, they come as two people. Sometimes they don't even have a logo. And after a crowdfunding campaign, after the exposure, after the success story, I can come to the office after a year and they have 10 employees, 15, and they're starting to sell it worldwide, their products. And for me, that's the best part of my job.
That's great. And what does it take to be successful in this business based on your experience? You know, we see that you work with a lot of big brands, and from your experience, what do you think is the difference between the people who can make it in this space and the others who are really not cut up for it?
So I would say the eyes. So what do I mean by the eyes? If you see the passion in the eyes, the fire, and the drive, then you will know that this person will be successful, because you know that he will put all his effort and will give everything that he has to make this company or project be successful, and that's, you can see a big difference between different people and different motivations, and those that have the drive, that they have the passion, that really want it, they can get it, and that's the big difference between people.
So the drive and the passion is really what helps differentiate an entrepreneur who will make it and one that's not really cut out for it.
Yeah, because if you don't have the drive and you don't really want it, it's a very tough world. It's very difficult
and expensive,
and also people will follow you because you have the drive. Okay, they want to taste this passion and to have it also, so they will follow you. And if you don't have the drive, they will say, no, that's not interesting. I will follow somebody else.
Great, Ron. Well, this has been a great interview. This has been our first one on the Gadgetflow podcast. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. Tell us where we can check out your website and some of your work.
So my website is corygroup.co. Corey is C-O-R-Y. You can see an example of several campaigns that we have done. You can see also some of my past campaigns in the advertising agencies. And most important, you can contact me from my website. I will be happy to answer questions. And of course, if you have a good campaign, talk to me. I can really, I would really want to help you and see you grow as other people that I helped.
Fantastic. Thanks again for your time. This has been a pleasure speaking with you.
Thank you, Jessica.
Thank you.
Thanks for listening to the Gadget Flow podcast. Make sure to subscribe on iTunes for more episodes and check out our website at thegadgetflow.com. Gadgetflow.com. Gadgetflow.com. Gadgetflow.com.